In this video, we will learn about variables in Dart. A variable is nothing but the name given to a memory location, where we can store a value. To define a variable in Dart, there are two ways. The first one is, we write data type. For example, let's say we have the data type as int, then we will write the variable name. For example, I want to define marks, and I will give the value as 75. Now I have defined a variable named marks and we have 75 as the value stored for this marks. Now if I pass marks to my print function, I will get 75 as the output, as you can see here. So this is the first way of defining a variable in Dart. With this example, we can say that Dart is a strongly typed language. That means we have to define the type while defining a variable. But it is optional, and Dart can automatically infer the variable types. And here comes the other way of defining a variable. Now this time, let's say I want to define my name. So what I can do is, I can also write where, this is a keyword, and then the variable name. For example, name equals to, I will put my name, let's say Bilal Khan. And we need to end the statement with a semicolon. And now we have a new variable named name, and the value for this variable is this string. Now in Dart, we can use single or double quote to define a string literal. For example, I can even write like this using double quotes. So if you want to use single quote in between, you can use double quote to define a string, or you can even use single quote to define a string if you do not have any single quote between the string. Or you can also use escape sequence to define a single quote using a single quote string, but that we will discuss in coming videos. So for now, we have a new variable and the type of the variable is string, but this time we have not defined the type for this variable. But Dart will automatically assign string type to this name. For example, after this, if I try to assign an integer to this name, let's say 11, I want to assign, then I am getting an error because the type of this name is string, and to string type, we cannot assign a number. So these are the two ways of defining variables in Dart. The built-in types of Dart are numbers, strings, booleans, lists, sets, maps, runes, symbols, and null. For now, we just need to care about numbers, strings, and booleans. We will discuss remaining types in coming videos. For example, if you want to define a Boolean variable, then you can write where is present equals to true, or you can define it like bool is present 1 equals to false. So whatever way you want to define your variable, you can use it. So we have discussed about the two ways to define a variable in Dart. Now all the variables that we defined are local variables because we defined the variable inside this main function. That means the variable are local to the scope of this main function, that is from this curly brace to this curly brace. The main function is the entry point of our Dart program. So whenever the function is started, the variables are initialized in the memory. Once the function ended, all variables are removed from the memory. And outside the main function, we cannot access these variables. But if we want to define a variable as global that we may want to access in any function, then we can define it outside the function body. And then it will be accessible in other functions as well. For example, I will define here, let's say I have a string full name and the value is, let's say my name again. And now I have one more function, let's say I have greet, and inside this function I will write a print statement and I will just print my full name. And here also inside my main function, I will print full name. So you can see we are able to access this full name inside this greet function and also inside this main function. So here this full name is global and we can access this variable inside any function. So that's it for variables in Dart. Thanks for watching.